Well, starting today, the convention center is going to be transformed into a homeless shelter to stop the spread of the coronavirus. This comes after the county announced that three people in shelters have tested positive. 10 News reporter Marie Cornell shows us how this helps with the city's goal of ending homelessness.
People from the bridge shelters will be moved here at the convention center, a way for the city to control the spread of the coronavirus, but also part of their mission to get people off the streets. Crews from the Alpha Project were packing things up right before people were picked up and dropped off at their new temporary home, the convention center. Because the convention center is so spacious, people will be able to practice social distancing, which couldn't safely be done in the shelters because there wasn't enough room, which is especially important now as three sheltered people have already tested positive for the coronavirus, with more expected to come. During the news conference, city leaders said they plan to move in 800 people, but the center will eventually house 1,500. This will happen in different phases. The first to move in will be those from the bridge shelters, while the city's outreach teams will continue working with those on the streets.
Our outreach teams and the HOT teams are going to be putting the word out there, and we're just, over time, we're going to expand out as far as we can.
While at the convention center, everyone will be monitored for symptoms, but will also get their basic necessities, all while representatives try and find them permanent housing.
It will offer the same services as our other shelters, including 24-hour security, meals, showers, restrooms, laundry services, ADA accessibility, Wi-Fi access, and most importantly, health screenings.
The mayor says funding for this effort comes from the city, the county, and the region. And when asked how long this effort would continue here at the convention center, he said for as long as it's needed. From downtown, Marie Cornell, 10 News.